Rheology describes gooey, sticky stuff. It's especially about the matter in between fluid and solid. If you have water or an elastic spring material, there are better models, but fluids like slime or food or cosmetics or plastics, these are well described by Rheology.
So this is a swallowing sensor. It records the sound of swallowing and will show you directly how good is your swallows. So we can use this for determining if someone has swallowing problems. We have developed a liquid that is similar to the slime that I showed you. It sticks together, it's elongated, it has elastic properties, and it doesn't enter the airways.
And this is the model of our throat that enables to study the relation between rheology and swallowing. Even if you have problem with the swallowing, we want to make sure that the bolus flow into the right way and does not end up in the airways.
To determine rheological properties, you need instruments, serometers. Sometimes you need a strong motor and a separate sensor and a fixed inner system. For other fluids and applications, you need an ultrasensitive sensor or just room for additional equipment. For more solid samples, you may need a small axial deformation to determine melting and glass transitions, or a large axial deformation to compare rheology to fracture properties of solid and semi-solid materials. The same rig can also be used to create a contraction flow for determination of extensional rheology. The high temperature systems are essential for melts, like here to determine the melting of our edible hot melt adhesive as compared to a conventional one.
I'm planning to do the rheology of the cement paste. Based on the rheology, you can see how the additives in the cement paste are having effect on the rheology. Also, how that cement paste is going to flow or the workability of the cement paste. So that is very important when it comes to application of the concrete or the cement in the real world.
I'm Lucrezia. I'm a master student at ETH in Zurich. The master project is about plant proteins and meat analogs. We treat the isolates with extrusion. You have the protein isolates and water, and then they go inside a heated barrel. The point of extrusion is to get fibers so that you have a similar structure and texture to meat. Most people would like to eat meat. Scientists try to replace it with something more sustainable and with health benefits too. The rheological properties of the melt and during extrusion are really important, and they affect the fibrous formation.
Consistency is also important when you want to 3D print food. 3D printing is mainly used for decorations, such as on cakes, but also for texture-modified foods. And you need a special rheological behavior so that each layer sticks to each other, or stick to the one below, but doesn't flow out. With 3D printing, you can tailor the texture and the nutritional content for people with, for example, swallowing disorders. And that is common when you get older. So you start with mashing up the real foods, which can either be vegetables or meat, and then you add egg and starch to create a texture that has some chewing resistance, but is then easier to swallow. And who knows, in a couple of years, 3D printers might be as common as microwave ovens are now.
These were a few examples of what rheology is. Join the networks and follow the links, and you will see many more.
I love slimy stuff.